Did you notice that Jesus asks the same question to Bartimaeus that he asked the apostles James and John? We heard it last week when the brothers said to Jesus, "We want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." And Jesus asks, "What do you want me to do for you?" The questions, the answers to these questions are very different. James and John, disciples within the inner circle, ask for seats of honor and power. They're asking for honor and power so that they will be even greater than they perceive themselves to be right now. Bartimaeus, a blind beggar who has no firsthand knowledge of honor and power, a man with no greatness at all, asks that he may see again. Unlike James and John, Bartimaeus does not seek a greatness above others. He is not asking for honor or power. Bartimaeus is only asking to see again. Because in seeing again, Bartimaeus would simply be like everyone else. Nothing special, just equal. Bartimaeus just wants to be restored and healed so that he would be like everyone else. I can only imagine what it was like for Bartimaeus to sit on the side of the road begging in order to sustain life. Bartimaeus might have wanted to be like the others, but when I read this story, I want to be like him. I want to believe in Jesus so much that I would walk away from everything I had, knowing without a doubt that all I needed, not only to survive, but to truly live, all I needed was Jesus. I want to be all in, knowing that if I abide in Jesus, all will be well, no matter if the outcome is not what I'm hoping for. I want to be like Bartimaeus, though in reality, I'm often more like the crowd. The crowd felt like they knew what was best. It was the crowd that stood in the way of Jesus' message. A roadblock trying to silence Bartimaeus because he was not like them. The crowd was righteous. He must be a sinner whose punishment was to become blind. Common thought back then. I think sometimes we as a people believe that it is actually possible that God's love can be blocked from any particular situation. We think that God's not getting there, that God's not a part of it. But the truth is, nothing can separate us from the love of God. I think we should just stop worrying about this, thinking that God can't get into places and situations, that God's not present already in all things. Bartimaeus was not to be silenced. Nothing was going to stop him from professing, there it is, the truth. He professes, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." Many sternly ordered Bartimaeus to be quiet. Be quiet. Close your mouth. We don't want to hear your voice. The words "sternly ordered" sound like the PG version to me. And that's the PG version. I mean, in our current news cycle, we hear of a variety of crowds claiming to know what Jesus wants. And these crowds are sternly ordering other people to do things or to not do things. And the words that I hear them say and the words on the signs that they're holding up are definitely not PG. I bet the words chosen by the crowd in today's gospel were much like what we are seeing in the news. Many sternly ordered Bartimaeus to be quiet. But he cried out even more loudly, "Son of David, have mercy on me." And Jesus stood still. I wonder why the Gospels tell us that Jesus stood still. I think when we stand still, we can actually experience what's going on around us. And Jesus did. And Jesus said, "Call him here." And the crowd called the blind man, saying to him, "Take heart, get up, he's calling you." For me, this is where the hope resides, at least today. Next time, maybe it's the hope shows up somewhere else, but for me today, this is where the hope resides. The people who had just been the roadblock trying to silence the blind man suddenly became the conduit for healing. Roadblock to conduit. Listen again. Jesus stood still and said, "Call him here." And they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take heart, get up, he's calling you." The crowd thought that they knew what was best in the presence of Jesus, that the lowest among them should be silenced, as not to get in the way of their relationship with Jesus. But what did Jesus do? Be quiet, you're getting in the way of my relationship with Jesus. Shush. So Jesus spoke to them directly. He spoke to them directly. And those words being spoken to them directly, it changed them. It's pretty powerful if you think about it. It changed them. When those who thought they knew best actually heard the word of Jesus, they were transformed. They became evangelists, assisting in the message of Jesus by sharing it with the blind man. They said, "Take heart, get up. He's calling you." Jesus didn't judge the people for their ignorance. He just healed them, and they participated. Bartimaeus already knew that Jesus had the power to heal, even before Jesus called for him. Bartimaeus knew this so much. It was such a certainty that his faith was so confident that he threw off his cloak, and in doing so, Bartimaeus did wholeheartedly, without reservation, what the rich man couldn't do. Bartimaeus gave away all that he had, the one thing in his life that resembled any ounce of security. Bartimaeus threw off his cloak and walked away from the past. He presented himself before Jesus, and he answered the question, "What do you want me to do for you?" "My teacher, let me see again." And Jesus said, "Go, your faith has made you well." Immediately he regained his sight and followed him on the way. Bartimaeus could have returned home. He was now clean, and he was restored. He was whole. No longer would he have been seen as less than, as worthless than other people. He could have had the life that I suspect he always wished he'd had. But he did something unexpected. He did something that only Bartimaeus did in the Gospels. Instead of going away, Bartimaeus followed Jesus on the way. He responded as one who was forgiven, restored, and strengthened through Jesus Christ. And the only thing he could do at that point was to follow Jesus. And following Jesus on the way, Bartimaeus became a conduit for others, a voice in the crowd sharing his faith story, helping to spread the message, to take heart. Get up. Jesus is calling you. Amen.